Templates are predefined pipelines that enable you to get started quickly with Azure Data Factory. If you're new to building pipelines, choosing from a gallery of templates will also help you overcome the challenge of a blank canvas. Gaurav Mehrotra is here to show us how today on Azure Friday. Hello, today on Azure Friday, I have Gaurav Mehrotra, who's going to show us some great new enhancements for Azure Data Factory that we call templates. So talk to me about what we're releasing.
So what we are saying with Data Factory now is that if you are a Day Zero user and you want to get quickly started with building Data Factory pipelines, we are releasing templates and we are announcing a template gallery where we have predefined templates to choose from. And you can essentially start from that and start to build your pipeline. And you can add more to it, but that's a good way for you to getting started with Data Factory by using those templates.
Great, great. Well, can you show us what some of these templates look like?
Yes, so essentially there are two entry points to this. So one is you can go to our overview page and we have this create pipeline from template. Or you could come to the author page and click plus and say pipeline from template. And this will open up our template gallery. And you can see that we have a bunch of out-of-box templates that we are providing here. So our goal is that by using these templates, we will improve the operational productivity of our customers. And there are different templates, as I mentioned, to choose from. And here you could choose from copy templates. So we have a bunch of templates for you to move data from different sources, like in this case, from S3 to Data Lake Store, from Google BigQuery, from Netezza to Data Lake Store. And then we've also different copy templates where we are kind of releasing some patterns as templates. Like there are a lot of customers who are trying to bulk copy their data from one database to another, right? So we have a bulk copy from database template where you can just select that and we essentially provide you information about what kind of a pattern this is using. So in this case, we get the partition list of the entire database that you're trying to move. And then we do for each partition, inside the for each, we have a copy activity to copy your data,
right?
And if you look over here, we provide that information. There are links to the documentation to get more information. And then all we are asking you as a user is to provide the connection information, right? So in this particular case, because this particular pattern uses an external control table to maintain the list of the database that has already been moved, so you just need to provide us where we can create that external control table. So you can select any connection or you could create new over here as well. So it's totally up to you which route you want to go. And similarly here, what is the source and what is the destination, right? So you can select any database source and you can select any database destination over here. And as you can see that we're already limiting it to what the database is. So once you click plus new, the only connections that you can create are the ones that we support for this particular template.
Okay.
Right. So you provide those particular values and then you click, so let's say in this particular case, I provide my Azure SQL database for control connection. I want to move data from my another Azure SQL database to my data warehouse. And I say, use this particular template. And at that point, we have created the pipeline, as you can see over here. And we are also guiding you through this process where we are telling you that once you say use this template, what are the required properties that you have to fill for this particular pipeline to operate. So if you click this, we take you exactly to the location of what needs to be filled. And you can look at more information of your pipeline in terms of settings. As you can see, we've already created the parameters and parameterized everything for you to quickly get started with all of this.
So it reduces the number of errors while I'm creating my pipeline, but it also gives me more consistency for how I might be creating my different pipelines.
Yes, because you could come in and say that I want to norm on a naming convention, right, for my pipelines. So in that ways, you could be consistent in terms of using this templates and get started with that naming convention. You could change it, obviously, but we are just providing one pattern and you can use any other pattern if you will.
Now, I love all these baked-in templates that we're providing out of the box, but what I'm really interested in is that tab that you have that says My Templates. Mm-hmm. Can you talk to me about that?
Sure. So with My Templates, what we are saying is that a lot of time customers have requirements where they want to save their existing pipelines as templates as well. And it's important because as an enterprise, you might have developed pipelines that different business units might want to use, right, with different configurations. So what we are saying is that you can save your pipeline as a template as well. So if I open up any particular pipeline, let's say if I open up my improved online traffic sales pipeline, you can now see save as a template button on the pipeline canvas. Once you click this, an important thing is that for you to save your pipeline as a template, you need to enable Git integration. And for this, we support both Azure DevOps Git or GitHub. So let's say in this particular case, I'll use GitHub to set it up. So if I provide my account, and once I provide my account, it automatically pulls all the repos that I have access to. If I select my repo, then I provide my collaboration branch. So it can be any branch. Generally, it is master. And then I'm saying that I want to import my existing resources to my repo as well. And then if I press save, at this point, whatever I have in my data factory, the code representation of that is being saved to the GitHub repo that I just selected. So if I go to this particular GitHub repo, which I just selected, and I'll see that all of that stuff is here.
Okay.
Now, all my data sets, integration runtime, link services, all the code representation is here. Now, if I go back, I'm now on the screen where I can save this pipeline as a template. It is telling me what name and description I want to use. It automatically pulls from the pipeline definition, but you can change it. It is also telling me in which Git location it's going to be saved. So it is going to create a templates folder inside the Git location, and that's where this is going to get saved. So if I click save, at this point, if I go back to my Git repo and refresh this, you'll see that there's a templates folder that got created,
right,
and then there's a JSON definition. So here we are not reinventing the wheels, we are just using ARM templates as a backend store. So once you click save as a template, we generate a full ARM template for this. So you can see that this entire template is here. And along with template, we also have a manifest file. And this manifest file is particularly for, like you saw on the template gallery, you have icons and all of that, right? So if you come in and submit, then we'll be able to store all of that information. So in this case, you can see that once I saved it, now in my template gallery, because I'm at the My Templates location, I can see this particular template got saved and it is being saved by me, so hence my name is over here. So all of this information is maintained in the manifest file.
That's great. So you have standard templates. Mm-hmm. I can create my own templates and save them and reuse those.
Mm-hmm.
What's coming next with this?
So if you look in the template gallery right now, like I mentioned, we have out-of-box templates, we have copy templates, we have SSIS templates. So if you want, a common pattern in SSIS is that you want to schedule your SSIS integration runtime to execute SSIS packages. So we have a template for that. And then we have transformation templates for doing ETL with HD Insight or Databricks. And then all of these templates that you see in the template gallery are in the Data Factory official GitHub location. So we have this GitHub location for Data Factory, and there's a templates folder, and you can find all the official templates here. Mm-hmm. Now, in future, what we are planning to do is we are going to create a certification process where any partner or SI can come and create a pull request to submit a template over here. And then we have a nightly process that takes whatever is submitted to this GitHub location, and it becomes available in our template gallery over here.
Great.
Right? So we will have a certification process. Once you submit an ARM template, we'll qualify it, make sure everything works before we say, yeah, it's good to go ahead and being available in the template gallery.
So we can expect that we'll just see more and more different types of templates to support lots of different data pipeline scenarios.
Yes.
That's
we will
fantastic.
Continue to add more templates over here as we keep going forward.
Okay. Is there anything else you want to share?
Yes. So with this, we have a full documentation on how you could use these templates. So we have in our, this is our public Azure documentation for Data Factory. So there's a template section over there, and you can essentially look at all the templates that we support, how you can get started with it. If you want more information about particular out-of-the-box templates, you can take a look at that as well. And then we have a blog post as well announcing the release of these templates.
Great. Well, thank you again for making time to share this important update with us today.
Yeah, thank you.
We've been learning all about templates in Azure Data Factory today on Azure Friday.